All right, we're going to shift our focus right now and talk about crime in the area. Tonight, police in St. Paul are working to find the driver of a stolen car that caused a fatal crash that involved a 70-year-old woman in the Payne-Phelan neighborhood on Sunday night. That crash comes as the owner of a St. Paul restaurant prepares to speak to Congress about crime in the metro area and the impact it's having on small businesses like his. Chef Brian Ingram will speak with the House Subcommittee on Oversight and Investigations tomorrow. Kent, what do we know the night before about his testimony?
Well, it's interesting, Jana, because the title of this hearing is Thoughts and Prayers Are Not Enough: How Mass Shootings Harm Communities and Local Economies and Economic Growth. But Chef Ingram, who owns the Gnome Pub and Hope Breakfast Bar in St. Paul, says he was invited by Republican Representative Tom Emmer to speak not about mass shootings, but about crime more generally and the impact it is having on his business, employees, and customers.
As the owner of a restaurant named Hope, Brian Ingram knows how this might look.
As a business owner, this may be one of the stupider things I could do. The last thing we want to do is scare our guests or scare people that are coming to our restaurants.
Ingram insists he hasn't given up hope on St. Paul or the Twin Cities.
Probably 3 feet high, 3 feet wide.
But he admits that it's been hard not to lose a little faith after seven break-ins at his various businesses in 2 years.
That doesn't include carjackings. That doesn't include our staff that have been assaulted on their way home. We've had one of our employees' cars stolen out of the parking lot where a group of individuals came in, searched the employee room, found his car keys in a pocket, and went out and stole the car. And for us, it's really the brazenness of it.
Is there anything in particular that you're frustrated with, say, the city of St. Paul on that has or hasn't happened in response to your break-ins?
For me, it's really judges and what's happening with our prosecutors and what's happening with this kind of release that's been going on. Like for us, super frustrating when somebody robs us and they're out of jail within 24 hours and then they come back and rob us again and then they come back and rob us again. And something that really touched us personally, we lost our kitchen manager just a few short months ago to a fentanyl overdose. We had his cell phone. We shared those messages with the police department and his drug dealer's texting back going, he's saying, I think something's wrong. And that drug dealer says, you'll be fine. And this young man was 24 years old and he died that night. That drug dealer, we know who he is. We know where he lives. And he's still on the streets. The folks that are breaking the rules know that they can get away with it. That's not good for everyday citizens.
Ingram says he doesn't believe that message is a political statement, though he is well aware that he was invited to speak to Congress tomorrow by a Minnesota Republican from outside of his district.
Are you worried at all about the politics of getting involved and going to Washington and lending your voice to something that seems to be used right now in political campaigns?
I'm petrified of that, but I think everybody is afraid to even talk about it right now because it is so politicized. I vote Republican, I vote Democrat, I vote for people that I believe in and I trust in. And that's really what I'm hoping our hometown understands through everything we've kind of tried to do over the last 2 years. And we're here to love our community, and to love our community means that we have to take stands. I'm willing to do that. Our family's willing to do that.
Though he won't specifically, again, be talking about mass shootings, Ingram points out that his participation was approved by Democrat Maxine Waters, who chairs this committee, and he is also the only small business owner who will be offering testimony tomorrow. So he believes that his input is something that will be valued by everyone on that committee.
All right. Thank you so much, Kent.